Hey guys, this is Jeff from GameStork, and we have some Super Bomberman R news.
GameStork, delivering news, reviews, and playthroughs like a newborn baby.
In addition to announcing new DLC, Konami released a free update for Nintendo Switch Super Bomberman R that dramatically improves its frame rate and adds new content. While the patch notes remain fairly vague, stating only that the frame rate of the entire game has been improved, players have reported a marked improvement in its performance. It's unclear at this point if it now runs at 60 frames per second, although most people at this point have determined that it does. But whatever the case, you should be able to enjoy a much smoother experience. Now, looking at some of the Super Bomberman R 1.3 update patch notes, it says, four new versus stages have been added to the shop: White Cross, Lagoon, Max Speed, and Power Zone. Two new series of accessories have been added to the shop, which are crowns and bombs. The frame rate of the entire game has been improved. We also made slight adjustments and improved the controls as well. Less lags are likelier to happen when every participant in the online battle has good network connection. If you want to find opponents with good connections, set other basic settings, network settings to the very left. Made it possible to press LR to change the inclination of the map in the story mode. You can now choose the strength of the computer on multiplayer battle. The strength of the five dastardly bombers on story mode has been adjusted. The difficulties of beginner and normal have been reduced, making it easier to beat them. Adjusted the heights and slopes on some maps to improve visibility. If you continue a certain number of times in the story, you will be able to continue without paying any more gems. Change the battle point increase decrease rate for the league battle, and fix other small bugs. So as you can see or hear, there's a lot of updates. Konami's really trying to give us the most and fulfill on the promise that they made to give us as much as they can and updates and things like that, so that that money that we spent, that $50, will be worth it. I don't know about you guys, but I really enjoyed Bomberman. I think it's a lot of fun despite its hiccups. Now I'm ready to get back in and play it some more and get online and see just how this thing works. I'm really excited about the possibility of 60 frames per second. As a matter of fact, as soon as I get done doing these videos here today, that's what I'm doing. I'm going to turn on Bomberman. So if it's something that drastic, I'll post another video. Thank you guys for watching. I appreciate you so much, and I'll see you next time. Be sure to like and subscribe below.